to come up with a plan to return $331 million that was part of the $25 billion national mortgage settlement of 2012 when the state has money available to do so. Robert Nasda, general counsel for the three groups that brought the lawsuit, said now that the California budget has swung to a surplus and Brown and lawmakers are debating what to do with it, the state is in a position to begin making payments. He said groups that sued California over the funds are seeking meetings with Brown and top Democrats and Republicans in the state Senate and Assembly on how to move forward with payments. It's not clear if that would be swept up into the budget talks that are currently underway between Brown and lawmakers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A new medical study on the effects of marijuana use confirms that everyone knows you're high and that you'll never stop feeling like this.
Everyone can smell the marijuana on your breath and on your clothes. Everyone is laughing at you.
Additionally, the in-depth report reveals that despite trying to act cool, you're definitely laughing too much and everyone is messing with you.
Your parents know you're high, your friends know you're high, strangers on the street know you're high. If you're young and you smoke marijuana, you will probably never be able to find a job. And if you're an adult, you will most likely be fired. If you hear a noise, that's probably the police, and you're probably going to jail.
While previous studies suggested that it's all good and that we're all made of the same stuff that makes stars, new research indicates that your brain got broken and you shouldn't have done this. Doctors say the study raises important questions such as, what if that wasn't just marijuana, and how are you going to get home?
This is the Onion News Network.
Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. For those of you who don't know what it means when you say a little word at the end of a telephone number, then you can figure it out. 855-450-FREE. It's Mark with you.
Ridley.
And Conan.
If, as you can tell, Ian is not here. I'm not exactly sure where he is, but it's not jail, I'm pretty sure, which you never know with Ian.
He's probably out chalking doing his second favorite thing.
Right. You know, hassling government bureaucrats in some manner or another. So you can call in and talk about whatever you want here on this live edition of Free Talk Live. You can also use Skype. Besides using the regular telephone number, 855-450-FREE, you can use Skype, which is lrn.fm. That's our username. You just send a contact request. We'll get to it probably in, you know, 5-10 minutes. And then you can call in and sound usually a bit better. And if you don't want to use Skype, you can always use 855-450-FREE or username lrn.fm on Skype. So there's been a story that has, it's been making the rounds. It's one of these, what's that quote from Noam Chomsky, Dave? The one where, you know, everybody should talk about stuff and not important things?
I don't have the exact quote. I'll maybe look it up later. But basically he was saying that if what you want to do to maintain like an authoritarian government is to allow a lot of vigorous debate about stuff that doesn't matter.
That's inconsequential.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or that's just minor.
Yeah. So here, let's vigorously debate this Rachel Donazel gal.
I don't think I can.
I can tell you that there are people listening that can.
So the question is, what are they doing right now that no one is paying attention to? Because it always seems to be something that gets slipped in during these silly debates, these national debates.
Do you think it is that the debates themselves are setups for the things sliding in? Because that's kind of what we were told about the Clinton administration with the Monica Lewinsky thing. He fires a cruise missile at an aspirin factory in order to make people stop, worrying about his, whatever he was doing there.
It wouldn't surprise me, but I am sure that when they see these things come up, they're definitely on the ball. Getting these things passed under the black of night, taking advantage of a good thing.
Well, we were a couple weeks ago. It was Caitlyn Jenner, Bruce now Caitlyn Jenner that we were supposed to talk about, and so now it's this Rachel Donazel here. And for those that don't know, what she is I have here a New York Times article, which I probably won't read much of. She is a gal who, I guess, was in charge of the NAACP in Spokane, Washington. Her ex-husband is black. Her child is black. Her brother is black, but she is white or was born white. And she's now identifying as black. She says here that she says, I identify as black, when she sat down to have an interview regarding this. When Matt Lauer of NBC's Today Show said, when did you start deceiving people? Ms. Dunzel would not concede that she had done so. And as I understand, she had actually had a situation in the past about 10 years or so ago. She's 37, so she hasn't had that much past. Where she actually, she had a lawsuit as a white woman saying that she was discriminated against at the university or something like that. So I'm not going to go and say that Ms. Dunzel is all there, right? Like, the pieces of information I have about her, she seems like a bit of a weird lady.
But I would agree.
Yeah, I mean, I can't get too excited about it from the standpoint. I feel like I have to talk about it because everybody's talking about it on talk radio. But, you know, I think that the position is, for me, is that we are told by science that race is something that you self-identify as. Now, if I ran around self-identifying as Aborigine, at some point or another, somebody's going to call me on the carpet, right? They're going to say, you weren't born in Australia, son. You were born in Sarasota, Florida. You grew up in Bradenton, right? Like, they're going to say, no, that's not the case. But, I mean, we're told that race is something you self-identify as. My best friend in the world, the guy I was best man at his wedding, he is half black, half white. And now he self-identifies as black, probably because he couldn't get away as identifying as white if he wanted to. Some other time he may have done that. But he lives in a pretty much a white world. He's married to a white woman. He lives in a largely white town. You know, all the people he hangs around with are white. It's not like he's acting like Uncle Tom. This is his life. That's just it. And, you know, I think that to some extent, your life is as you create it, as opposed to the life that you were born into. And if this lady self-identifies as black, I don't care. When I took my 23andMe test, this DNA test where I spit in a jar and sent it off someplace and people told me, hey, here's some stuff about your DNA. I found out things that I didn't know. I didn't know that my maternal line began with an Ashkenazi Jewish woman. That makes me Jewish by all standards. Now, I didn't know that and I wasn't raised that way. But, you know, there you go. It's my father's lineage somehow has an Ethiopian Jew in it. So yeah, they've got a black guy, too. I mean,
it's interesting how in some places ethnicity and religion are conflated, right? You know, like Jewish would be an example, or Bosnian Muslim or Bosnian Croat. That would be examples where supposedly a Croat is just a Catholic who is South Slavic in ethnicity, right? There's right. No difference, really, between such a person and a Bosnian Muslim. But because there's this different religion, it's become conflated with
an ethnicity.
With ethnicity, right?
Yeah. So here in the United States, we really don't have that going along so much. Now, I think it's strange that this lady would put, you know, skin toner on and get a perm and all these things, you know, run around with her green eyes. And I can see why some people feel deceived or whatever, but I just don't, you know, either race is something that you self-identify as or it isn't.
Yeah, as long as she's not telling lies, like this happened to me when I was a kid, and I was she said things like I was there was a Ku Klux Klan KKK on her front yard or something. Yeah. And she was, I don't know, mistreated because she was black. Now you start saying things like that, then you're going to town with a lie.
I think everybody has a way to talk about how they were mistreated because of who they are.
Mm-hmm.
And I've heard at one point or another, I believe Michelle Obama talked about how Barack Obama was asked for some coffee by a visiting dignitary at the White House. And
wow.
I guess she felt that was terrible. The story I told after that was,
yeah, that's their idea of an atrocity.
Yeah.
When what's their body count per day now?
Right. None. When I went to Home Depot, people sometimes will ask me where things are and how to fix stuff. I don't know why. I'm not wearing an orange apron. I don't generally wear an orange apron, but that's fine.
Maybe you just look industrious.
Right. I have a look. I have that look. Like, I can fix something.
You look like you can get it done.
Right. And that doesn't make me angry that somebody is mistaking me for a $10 an hour employee.
Like,
because I have been a $10 an hour employee.
If anyone could get you coffee at the White House, it's President Obama.
Right. He should know where the effing coffee is. If somebody comes to my house and says, Could you get me some coffee?
Well, yeah, he's going to know which of Michelle Obama's 20 attendants is good at getting coffee.
I guess I just don't find
Marie
this to be
a
terrible thing.
Let them eat cake. By the way, your friend identifying as black, you have two different ideas here. Hypodescent and hyperdescent. And hypodescent is the automatic assignment of children of mixed union or mating between members of different socioeconomic groups or ethnic groups. And it goes to the subordinate group. So in the U.S., white-black mixes will identify as black.
Okay.
It's very, very rare that a mixed race will identify as white because, well, according to this, you know, the blacks are the minority and the whites are supposedly the dominant superior race.
But, you know, all things being equal, race is supposed to be something that you cannot change. That's the reason why one is not in the right when they are against a race, because they are against something that a person cannot change.
That makes some sense.
So if you can change it, then
it's a free country,
like building,
right?
It's like building a time machine. It starts to throw all the rules out, you know?
Right. If you can change your sex these days, I mean, why can't you change your skin color?
That's right. I mean, I claim no race at all. And sometimes that makes people angry because I haven't taken some kind of side or because I have the privilege to do such a thing.
Right.
But I say, you know, what has being white ever done for me? I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of that. Thanks so much. Maybe I can jump a little higher. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Going to get into your calls here in just a moment. But I want to tell you about gold.freetalklive.com. If you're looking to get any precious metals, gold, silver, as a matter of fact, they've got all kinds of other stuff over there at Midas Resources. Start off at gold.freetalklive.com. Midas Resources is the sister company to Genesis Communications Network, our network. And we have I've done business with them for years. I've been getting gold and silver from them for a very long time. And actually platinum, too. And I recommend them. If you're going to get gold and silver, this is the place to go. They make it as painless as they possibly can. They get it out to you so you have it in your hands. They don't hold it on site. It's a great organization to work with. Gold.freetalklive.com. We've got the telephone number there, or I can give it to you here if you'd like. It's gold.freetalklive.com. Do your gold and silver purchasing there. The telephone number is 877-857-9938. 877-857-9938. Let's go to Chris calling in from North Carolina. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live. What is on your mind, sir?
Hey, guys. I kind of wanted to touch base on the excellent argument you got into last night about the burning of flags and whether or not it is activism.
Yes, hold on.
How everybody stands on that.
Let me recap real quick for folks that are just tuning in, didn't hear last night's show. So Ian posted on Free Talk Live's Facebook page a post that was made by Shire Dude on Ian's blog, Free Keen, where they were burning little tiny toothpick flags, you know, like the kind of flags you'd put in a cupcake or something.
Or a drink.
Yeah, or a sandwich, or, you know, that kind of thing. Just a toothpick with a little flag on the end. And apparently they've been doing burning these little tiny toothpick flags at events for several months. And for whatever reason, they made a video of it. And okay, so there's, and then Ian identified it as Free State Project Early Movers, you know, making sure to attach the Free State Project's name to something that might not entirely be called activism. So there you go, Chris. I think I've brought everybody up to speed.
Yes, well said. Well, my opinion as an outsider looking in down here in Charlotte, I would have called myself like a liberal Democrat maybe a year ago.
Okay.
And I used to listen to you guys back in the day, and I picked you back up and I started listening more and more. And it seems to me that you just have so much material if you want to, critique the government and the things that they do wrong and ways to go about doing it. And whenever you do something like that, it's almost just shock value. Like you're appealing to the lowest denominator because you know it's going to piss off 99.9% of the people who see it, because a lot of people, when they see the flag, they don't think of government. They think of their hometown that they grew up. They think of their family. And a lot of people, that's what it means to them. Whether it's right or not is up for debate. But when you burn it, all you do is anger people, yep. and you. I'd say
I
you're,
hate
you're
you
really
and everything you stand for. You suck, is what people hear when they see a flag burning, and they also hear the sacrifices made by family members and you know, people that they have emotional attachments to. So they think of people dying on the beaches of Omaha Beach. There, by the way, mm-hmm. not that many people died on Utah Beach. Omaha Beach might have been a mistake. Mm. Just saying. Mm.
Well, also, I mean, if you think about it, if the flag stands for the liberation of Auschwitz and Bergen-Belsen, and to some extent it does, it also has to stand for the massacres of Philippines during the guerrilla war around 1902,
yep.
and the other nasty things that the federal government has done, and all the terrible things that it's doing to the people who support it. I mean, by sucking out, 15-20% of their income every year.
Yeah, don't forget the regulations, what they do. So, Chris, liberal Democrats aren't generally known as people that are big, anti-flag burners. What,
Well, it's not that I'm an anti-flag burner so much. I mean, me personally, I could really care less. To me, it's just yet another symbol that's kind of thrown in my face every day.
Yeah.
But I will tell you, family and friends, I've grown around Southern Republicans who are about as hardcore as you can get. I mean, you're just not going to open their eyes up when you do something like that. They're just going to go to "I hate you," yep. and that's really not what we should be trying to achieve. It should be more "I love you" than hate. If you want to bring people in, use
positive
emotions. Like I said, there's a stack of material that's a mile high that you can go to and that works and makes sense. And instead, you're going to appeal to the lowest common denominator by doing something that most people consider very offensive.
Yeah, yesterday what I called the flag was a religious symbol. And when it comes to religions, people are willing to die for them. That's kind of part of the whole gig with a religion, right? Whether you're talking about Christianity or Islam, we can certainly find lots of examples of people being willing to die for their religion in that case. But I really believe that patriotism is, whether it's the U.S. patriotism or whatever country it is, there's people who are choosing to die for something that is below minimum wage, usually, is what a private's getting paid. They're giving their lives for this. So
and they're also given hero status for doing so. They're getting on a wall on a plaque somewhere because they died for the country, for their patriotism.
Or the willingness to die, too. I mean, don't forget the
pictures. It's no different than these Islamic terrorists, supposed terrorists, who are strapping vests on and running into...
You can say that because you're a veteran. I cannot. but that's part of the religion, right? Like, you get to say those things because you've spent your time in the temple. I, however,
haven't. Well, there are differences, but they're both good and bad differences.
Yeah. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that when you make somebody angry enough by spitting in their face about patriotism, you're going after the thing that they're willing to die for,
yep.
and that means that they're liable to kill you.
And by the way, my next door neighbor, who I get along with splendidly, he actually has a stupid flag memorial. He's got it hanging in his backyard. He's got spotlights going up to it so it shines at night. Burning a little, any kind of flavor of flag would be, absolutely the wrong thing, and we would be mortal enemies afterwards, because he's really, really into his flag.
He's into that flag, yeah.
But then we can talk about anti-government this and that.
Yeah.
But
while he's got a light on his flag in his backyard,
right.
you can discuss, whatever it is that you have with the government. It's absolutely
and a lot
right,
of things,
Chris.
And a lot of things we agree with, but, that would cross the line. In so many ways, and we would be enemies, from that day after.
That'd be it. Chris, you're absolutely right.
Yeah. I think the last point I'd like to make, though, is, as far as absolutely you can make the comparisons to people, like ISIS and terrorists and how they wave their flags around and screaming in the streets, but the Free State Project, as far as I know, is not trying to attract ISIS and terrorists. They want Americans to come and make things right.
There's an awful lot of people from other countries in the Free State movement.
Yeah, there's probably
I wouldn't debate that, but 90% of your listeners are not going to be terrorists in Afghanistan.
Nope.
So just a thought.
Thanks for the call, Chris. Appreciate it. 855 450 free. Yeah, I had Derek J and Ian on last night for this one, and I just couldn't get the point pass. It was 2-on-1 and I've spent 12 years now arguing with Ian over nonsense. I don't get as whipped up as I used to. But Yeah. You know, what are you going to do?
Ian goes for shock value.
Yeah. He thinks the controversy is always good. Somebody said, you know, that all press is good press to him. He believed it. Yeah. He believed him. 855-450-3733. 855-450-FREE. Can you think of any value to burning the flag? Love to hear it. 855-450-FREE on Free Talk Live.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Anyone can publish on the internet, but not everyone is publishing material suited for online reading. According to the Yahoo Style Guide, it cautions that internet content has a few seconds, three or less, to encourage people to read more, to take action, or navigate to another one of your pages. So make it easy for readers to pick and choose. Isn't that the way you poke around online? Use short words, short sentences, short paragraphs, bulleted lists, and short pages. Front load what you write, putting the most important information at the beginning of headlines and paragraphs and sentences. Same goes for your keywords. What someone would likely type into the search box on Yahoo or Google. For more tips on communicating better online or in a job interview or everyday life, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
I look up on internet and tried to research some stuff that everybody's been talking about. And, you know, everybody. It's all true.
What?
It's true.
What is?
Everything that's going on in this country.
The heck are you talking
everything
about?
Everything that you're talking about. I'm talking about 9/11.
We don't
I'm
talk about that.
About everything.
you're being incredibly vague.
I know what's going on. I mean, people get an airplane and they talk about, they were talking on this plane and they were doing this from that to this and that.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Cell phones didn't work back then.
What is this and that? You need to be a lot less vague because I don't know what you're talking about.
Everything, like, Dale. Everything is true.
Everything is true. Okay, that's going on in this country.
Yes, what I'm trying to tell. Everything is true, but they will not listen.
Everything.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever you want. We've already two segments, and we've talked about two different things. We've talked about this Rachel Dunazel gal who apparently was white, and now she's self-identifying as black, and, you know, everybody's talking about her. And we talked about flag burning, which was the topic from last night's show. So 855-450-FREE if you want to talk about either of those things. But another thing we've been keeping an eye on, Dave Ridley, as a matter of fact, we had Nicholas Nikolaisen on here from Liberland. He's, I don't know, some kind of official there with the new country of Liberland.
Well, he sure sounded credible. I made a point of listening to that early, even though I hadn't gotten up to the 14th in my listening yet. I listened to that whole archive of his interview. And it's,
what, you're behind listening to Free Talk?
Yes, it always takes me a couple days.
All we ask is 21 hours. Excuse me. Yeah, 21 hours a week, man.
Like
a second job.
And he sounded very credible, yeah. It was refreshing to listen to him.
So, you know, what they'd done is they'd taken about four people who had gone to their the Liberland, the Croatian police had taken another four people to jail, and they're claiming that, you know, this is, we're just being nice to you people that only get arrested once, but the second time we're going to hold you for a very long time in a very nasty jail.
Yeah, this is a concentration camp country, so it's something to bear in mind, or at least a country that has run concentration camps within the last 25 years.
And what are the charges against these guys? Are they poaching? Are they
basically
living up?
They're crossing into Croatia from an unapproved checkpoint.
Ooh.
So they're going into this piece of land that is neither owned by Croatia nor by Serbia. Neither of them want it. It is a legitimate terra nullius, and they are, you know, there's also an island aspect to it, so it's like a little peninsula and a little island, and it's about 3 square miles total, and it's a, you know, it's this unclaimed piece of land. They've claimed it. They've said, we are a country. And our country is Liberland, and they've put together a constitution and all kinds of things that they've done. They're working on a constitution, a crowdsourced one. And it's interesting to see a new nation come out of nothing. And there's a lot of people involved. But what the Croats are doing is arresting people for basically crossing out of and crossing into Croatia at an unapproved checkpoint. They won't put one up there.
Mass arresting, really, if it's 24 arrests, like you guys were reporting
total.
The other day,
yep.
And treating some completely inhumanely.
I wonder.
According to the Liberlanders, at least.
I wonder if they get told when they get released that if they really want to try this, they need to move to Somalia.
Right, that's what
Don't try this in Croatia. Just go to Somalia rest of them.
That's what they tell every one of the libertarians. I can tell you the Somalis, if you go there and try to set up a country inside their country, they're not going to like it either.
Nope.
You know, wait a second. You just showed up here and you're going to set up your own country and, you know, no, that's not going to happen.
You know, I think the Mexicans like these freedom types that escape the U.S. to go hang out and, you know.
They're not going to give you a piece of Mexico, though, to do it.
Yeah, you can't just go out in the desert and just, you know, set up a hut.
Yeah.
But as long as you take your money with you and get a job and stuff, that they love that kind of stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. There's all kinds of countries where people do what you're referring to is like the permanent traveler status.
Mm-hmm.
What people do is they get residency in one country that's different than where their citizenship is, which is different than where their business is registered, which is different than where their bank accounts are, and they just do all these kind of different countries and use the aspects of the, you know, every country has different rules, so you'll want to do your banking in, say, the Cayman Islands and, you know, have your residency in Mexico, but your citizenship in, you know, the United States or Canada and, you know, these kind of things. Now, the U.S., if you make more than, I think it's $90,000 or $95,000 per year for an individual, they still claim your income. So unlike every other country in the world, they actually claim the income that you make outside of the country, which I think is the best argument for, you know, citizenship being the modern serfdom or slavery. Who could possibly claim the fruits of your labor when you aren't in, you know, what country could possibly do that? How, I mean, you can only be a master. They're claiming to own your body even when you're not inside the country. It's one thing to say, well, you're in the country and you're using our facilities and all those sorts of things. You have to pay the taxes and we have our taxes on income, so that's how you have to pay. That's the rules. But it's another thing entirely to say, hey, you out there, wherever you are,
on your boat,
send us back money because right. we own you. God bless America.
It's for your own good.
You hate God, you hate Jesus and America if you don't send us money.
Yeah, did Soviet, did the Moscow government in the Cold War ever claim that, that Soviets living outside the Soviet Union were required to pay taxes to the Soviet Union for money they earned in Geneva or in France?
The governments that, okay, so I believe I have read somewhere, don't take this as gospel, that only North Korea and the United States are the only governments that claim that you owe income tax when you're outside the state. Now, I know the United States does. I can't imagine there's too many people making too much, you know, the whole North Korea thing's just a weird place anyway, so I don't even know whether to believe that. But, you know, I'm going to look it up during the break, see if I can figure it out. Regardless, I don't think if people are giving up citizenship, they're not giving it up to go to North Korea. I mean, that's the last guy who did that was probably the Korean War. I believe I saw a documentary on a deserter who went over to the other side there. And apparently, basically, he's just employed as their state white guy. You know, doesn't have really much to do with.
I'm looking at the Liberland website. I like what they got going on there. They got a good site set up.
Yeah,
I like their motto to live and let live.
They're very freedom oriented. You know, a bunch of liberty types or voluntarist types. They're trying to make a go of it. So Dave, I guess the Croatians are you know, still bothering the Liberlanders. And you said you wanted to tell about a Croat atrocity every time they just to respond every time they did something bad.
Yeah, every time they commit some kind of an abuse against the Liberlanders,
and
I think we should.
The countries like Croatia and Serbia, they really hate to have their atrocities talked about, right?
Well, I think the Croats hate it more.
Okay.
But it's interesting to watch the dynamic, the way the Croats are handling this versus the way the Serbs are handling it. Part of it may just be the way their territorial dispute is playing out. But Croatia essentially won the Balkan Wars. Slovenia could be argued to have won also. And Serbia basically lost. They played to a draw in Bosnia, but most of the war, I mean, they lost in Croatia. They lost in Kosovo. And so I think the Croats, the government, just, they sort of haven't learned the lesson, right? You know, they haven't learned the lesson that atrocities breed chaos. It's more like atrocities breed victory, right?
Oh.
And not everything the Croatian government and its militias did in the war was inappropriate. Some of it was just self-defense in a war of independence. But there were a lot of radical atrocities committed, especially during the Bosnian War. And I wanted to, each time they committed, I wanted to bring up another historical atrocity just because of this modern atrocity. And maybe the more historical atrocities we bring up, the less they'll want to commit modern atrocities. But this is the destruction of the Stari Most at Mostar, which is in Bosnia. This is the most, probably the most well-known structure in former Yugoslavia. Was this 427-year-old bridge in Mostar that the Croatian government-backed forces deliberately destroyed for no particular reason.
You know, somehow I even think it's worse when they blow up architectural stuff, you know, in these historical architectural things. I mean,
or paintings.
Yeah, I mean, I shouldn't feel this way. Human life is worth more, but God, it makes me so upset.
A 400-something-year-old bridge, or maybe it's a monument that's been standing for 500 years.
How about the Library of Alexandria? I'm still angry at the Christians for that crap.
Yeah. So from Wikipedia.org, it leads the section by calling it Pearl Harbor, which is exactly what the Croatian attack in Bosnia was at the beginning. But the destruction of this bridge happened later on in this, you know, roughly one-year-long war. And it says, well, I guess I'll quote it after the music is over when we come back.
855-450-3733. Am I wrong to be so upset about the destruction of architectural treasures compared to human life? 855-450-FREE or LRN.FM on Skype.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict.
Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at FIJA.org.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lawns to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin and stays strong for 24 hours. New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines, refers to first dose only. Starts working in 1 hour. Use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse
you are?
Me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make
wait,
a lot of comments. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek Jay's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and, well, you can talk about anything here on this live edition of Free Talk Live with Mark.
Oh, I'm Ridley. That's right. I was thinking about that for a minute.
Conan.
Still getting used to this whole setup, huh, Ridley? That's how we've been doing it here, but you're relatively new on the show. Tell folks about what you do at the Ridley Report.
Oh, it's like a poor man's TV station. I go up and ambush interview politicians and bureaucrats about the bad things they've done and then put it all on YouTube.
Yeah, do you ever get them on the good things?
Well, sure.
So, but most of it's bad because that's just the nature of politicians.
Yeah, it's kind of boring, too, if you walk up to someone and say, I would like to let you know that I agree with you.
Yes, you can get all the fluffing that you want to get from the local newspaper when it comes to politicians, you know. Hey, I mean, they name bridges after these people, for God's sakes. It shows just how, you know, how
if,
much they...
If you bridges ever, to nowhere.
If you ever go to any of these meetings, which Ridley pretty much lives at, ambushing these guys, there's always some old lady in the crowd, and she's like, I'm so proud of you guys and all the good things you've done. Giving your lives for us, you know, and that lady is always there for some reason. And yeah. So, and it's always a different old lady, but
they always, they and the politicians really seem to think that the only good work is government work. Mm-hmm. You know, they, you know, that's your not-for-profits are fine and your businesses are fine and everything.
But if you want the roads cleaned and picked up of litter,
yeah,
there's no way that some company or business in the, you know, in the area is going to volunteer their time to stay on top of that. They've got to pay some guy to cut the grass and take care of business. Otherwise, it'll just be chaos.
Yeah, we couldn't possibly live with, you know, organizations competing for your business in whatever areas it is that they're competing. Oh, we have that everywhere except for the areas
you mean,
that the
you mean competing claims. And actually driving down the prices and actually probably bringing up the level of service because of competition?
That's how supply and demand works, yeah. Isn't it?
That's right.
855-450-FREE. By the way, I just did get notified that it was China, not necessarily North Korea, that does tax its citizens outside of their borders. So the U.S. and China are the two countries in the world where if you're born as a citizen, they own you forever until you decide to give up your citizenship. And, well, you pay them another tax to get out. There's an exit tax. A friend of mine is giving up his U.S. citizenship, or has recently, and he had to pay a tremendous amount of his net worth just to get out.
So when you say exit, it's not you die, because
no.
That's that tax. Now there's also you leave the borders forever, and you have to pay us in order to do so.
Yeah, you have to be pretty dedicated as far as you know, wanting to you know, leave the U.S. But I mean, for some people, it makes the most sense to give up their citizenship. More people are giving up their citizenship. Like it's multiples of a few years ago. People are giving up their citizenship and getting away from the U.S. I don't know what that means, but it seems like an indicator of something.
Are any of these people giving it up and they're still in the States? They're just living somewhere out in the woods or up on a mountaintop?
I don't think you can do that. You basically have to get another citizenship to give up your citizenship. There doesn't seem to be any country that will let you live statelessly.
Right.
And so that's you basically have
then you
to
become,
switch.
Then you become one of them sovereigns, and then you, right. You know, you next thing you know, you're shooting up cops on the freeway.
I guess. This is the sort of the fallacy of the, you don't like it here in America, you get out, move and smolia. That nonsense is because, well, I think that citizenship is free-range serfdom. The only reason I say free-range serfdom is because if I say free-range slavery, people get all up in arms. Well, but slavery has existed for as long as humans have existed. And
it's still going on.
Right.
Like we,
it's morphed, you right. know. Like we live a better life now than our ancestors did, you know, 100 or 1,000 generations ago.
That's because we've had an extra 100 generations to develop technology and make the most of that small portion that the government allows us to have.
Right. So, I mean, we've always done it. All we've done, all that's ultimately been done is slavery has morphed into this new form that everybody's fine with being around.
And yeah, exactly. There are far fewer slaves who are actually revolting and running off the plantation and causing a ruckus because it's been dumbed down to such a level that it's almost all right.
I don't know if it's Harriet Tubman or Sojourner Truth that's this one's ascribed to, but I freed 1,000 slaves and I'd free 1,000 more if they knew there were slaves.
I think it was Tubman.
Yeah, I don't know which one it is, but you know, my God, that is so true today with the idea that people don't know how the government claims their body and their property.
Right. The best kind of slave is the one who doesn't realize it and it's just their head is still stuck in the sand and, you know, you can lead them around all day.
I was taught the definition of socialism, and I know this upsets some socialists out there, is government is the government ownership of the means of production. Well, there ultimately really are only two means of production. Human labor and the fruits of the earth. You know, where I live, my income is taxed, which is the fruit of my labor, and my property is taxed.
Right.
the only organization that can claim money from me on a regular basis at the pain of having my, in my case, my body, my, you know, my freedom taken away, or the case of my property, having my property taken away, my family thrown out on the street. The only organization that could do that is the organization that owns it. You can't take somebody else's property or make them pay you on a regular basis unless you own them and own their property. So to claim otherwise, this is simply, I like to say, a soft slavery because, you know, people don't, it's not the same, right? Like nobody's out there with a lash.
It's not always soft. I mean, what's the body count in the United States now of police killing, what is it, about 1,000 people a year, 500? What's the?
It was about 1,400 in last year, and I guess we're on par to hit that this year. I'm hoping the numbers will get turned around with enough of these protests and riots and things that are going on.
Yeah, and the example that pretty much all the other Western countries are setting of killing about a person a year.
Yeah, I mean, many of the other Western countries don't have numbers anywhere near what the U.S. has, and it's bizarre. So, yeah, I mean, in those cases, well, I mean, people don't identify with that, though, Ridley. I mean, they don't think that they can be shot, right? Like, I'm not holding a knife.
Oh, no, they're going to get blowed up by a terrorist. They're not going to get shot by a cop. That's only happens in the movies.
Right, they're afraid of terrorists, which the likelihood of being killed by a terrorist is significantly lower than the likelihood of being killed by a cop.
Yes, yeah, 8-1, last I heard.
Yeah, so, I mean, people don't identify with that. It's the other, you know, those bad guys. There's the one getting shot by the police, or it's those bad guys.
Yeah,
they
do identify with kids being told they're not allowed to run a lemonade stand.
They certainly do identify with that.
And that happens all over the U.S.
Right. If you owned your property, you could run a lemonade stand on the front lawn, or your kids could. And if you can't, I'm
exaggerating, by the way. It doesn't happen all over the U.S., but there are, you know, multiple cases.
There's story after story after story of lemonade stands. So
the things you grew up doing are illegal.
I wish that I had some better terminology than say soft slavery or a softer form of serfdom.
Soft fascism was what Ron Paul called it.
It's fine, but I mean, I know people get turned off by the idea that, you know, that we're essentially, this is just a new form of slavery. But I wish somebody would rebut it. Like, that's the problem is you know,
it's
most
slavery, but not chattel slavery.
It's right. It's, well, slavery is a big subject. Julius Caesar.
And it's partial. It's not complete slavery.
Yeah, no, there is no complete slavery. But Julius Caesar was a slave before he was Caesar. So he bought his own freedom. Slavery has taken all kinds of different forms throughout human history. And honestly, you know, people had their freedom bought from them. Like, you know, a slave would be freed, and then he would go back and get some money and free his wife or whatever from the master. I mean, these things happened in antebellum South. So it's not like it's that unusual. It's just that it's such a loaded situation. You can't say that. Well, I can tell you, I can back it up with facts, but no one wants to listen. Facts are just these annoying things that get in the way of our emotions, it seems like, in this country.
So now, if you can rate slavery by how much of your property they take from you, whether it's what grows on your land or your income, the fruits of your labor, what percentage of slave would we be, say, here in New Hampshire? So we're obviously not, I think
tax
we're lower.
Tax burden's lower here, is that what you're saying?
Right. Theoretically, 30%.
About 30%?
But in
most
practice.
Most of it's U.S., though.
In practice, the costs of all goods you buy are unofficial, are
driven up by taxes,
unnaturally high, and there's a multiplier effect. So each time that property, like each component of your computer, went through all these different taxes to get into your computer. So the Libertarian Party, I guess 10 years ago, is estimating that like a Ford Taurus should cost about $2,000, but it unnaturally cost, you know, $15,000, $16,000, $18,000 because of government intervention.
Wow. I hadn't heard that, but I wouldn't doubt it at all. And the government intervention isn't just taxes necessarily. There's all kinds of regulations that drive up pricing. Now, regulations or certifications or rules would exist in the marketplace absent the government, but so I often find those things difficult to exactly nail down. You can give us your comments at 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. ZOG.ninja. Code FTL.
DVD. Books. Music. Instruments. Periodicals. Computers. Software. Electronics. Photo. Cell phone. Office products. Home and garden. Bed and bath. Furniture. Kitchen. Pet supplies. Automotive. Hardware. Apparel. Shoes. Jewelry. Grocery. Healthcare. Sports and outdoors. Toys. Games. Used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done. Get a great deal. And a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.02 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $241. Antiwar.com reports UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is pushing for another humanitarian ceasefire in Yemen as the Geneva talks get underway, saying a two-week ceasefire for the start of Ramadan would allow large amounts of aid into the increasingly desperate country struggling under a Saudi-led naval blockade. The early news out of Geneva is not looking good, however, with the Saudi-backed exile government saying they are willing to discuss a limited ceasefire, but only if the Houthis agree to surrender every major city in the country as a condition. The Houthis have been pushing for an unconditional ceasefire and have been keen on restarting transitional talks, which effectively crumbled in January with the resignation of President Hadi, whose forces the Saudis are trying to reinstall militarily. The Hadi remnants don't appear keen to talk transition, however, at least not from their current weak position. While the first offer is obviously going to be rejected, the fact that the two sides both entered the talks at all shows a tacit recognition that a military victory simply is not going to happen, and that eventually they're going to have to come to terms.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports even though cannabis was legalized in Colorado, it has not been at the federal level. Therefore, companies can fire employees for using the substance, according to the Colorado Supreme Court. Brandon Coates, a quadriplegic medicinal cannabis patient, was fired in 2010 from his job as a telephone operator for Dish Network after testing positive for the substance. Dish never suggested Coates had worked stoned or used cannabis on the job, but dismissed him because of its no-tolerance policy for substances. Lawyers for Coates argued that Colorado law states it's illegal for workers to be terminated for participating in lawful activities off the job. A trial court and a court of appeals dismissed the claim, siding with Dish Network that medicinal cannabis use is not a lawful activity covered by termination laws. The Colorado Supreme Court upheld the earlier decisions. The panel of judges wrote in the opinion, "The Supreme Court holds that under the plain language of Colorado's lawful activity statute, the term lawful refers only to those activities that are lawful under both state and federal law. Therefore, employees who engage in an activity such as medical cannabis use that is permitted by state law but unlawful under federal law are not protected by the statute. A statement on Coates' lawyer's website said the ruling, though devastating for them, was important because there is previously no legal precedent for how a company could handle an employee who uses medicinal cannabis. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. Reuters reports a California judge has ruled that the state is obligated to pay $331 million in mortgage relief funds it used to bolster its finances, but stopped short of ordering that the money be turned over to homeowners hard hit by the mortgage and foreclosure crisis. Instead, Judge Timothy Frawley of Sacramento County Superior Court, in his ruling on Friday, said it is up to Governor Jerry Brown and lawmakers to come up with a plan to return $331 million that was part of the $25 billion national mortgage settlement of 2012 when the state has money available to do so. Robert Nasda, general counsel for the three groups that brought the lawsuit, said now that the California budget has swung to a surplus and Brown and lawmakers are debating what to do with it, the state is in a position to begin making payments. He said groups that sued California over the funds are seeking meetings with Brown and top Democrats and Republicans in the state Senate and Assembly on how to move forward with payments. It's not clear if that would be swept up into the budget talks that are currently underway between Brown and lawmakers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The manatee is a solitary creature, drifting along in the warm, peaceful shallows. They are not usually held in a small glass enclosure with three other male manatees hell-bent on the violent forced sex that I, for real, saw with my own eyes while alone one night at SeaWorld, San Diego. A distant relative of the elephant, the manatee has a prehensile upper lip which it uses to gather food. It also has a large penis. Classified as endangered, human boaters often cause serious wounds to manatees' flippers, rendering it difficult for this one poor little rescue manatee to escape a large male manatee intent on unwanted anal intercourse. One needed not to look in that little manatee victim's cold, soul-sapped eyes to know this was not the first time this had happened, nor would it be the last.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-453. It's 855-450-3733. You can give us a call and talk about whatever's on your mind. Last hour, we hit on a lot of subjects. We were talking about that gal, Rachel, whatever her name is.
She just wants to be black.
Yeah, that gal.
At heart.
Yeah, the NAACP president from Spokane lady that apparently was white and now black. And we spoke about the flag burning and the concepts of slavery. Was really talking about how we have, come to accept what slavery is and what it isn't, and we won't, we don't have good terminology for essentially the bondage to the government that we have today.
Right. If you say slavery in polite society, they immediately think that you're blowing things out of proportion. And no, there was slavery one time, and it was those black people who were whipped and chained, and they were brought over on boats, and they had to go, go through the cotton fields, and their family, and they were separated from their families or not. So if you call yourself a slave, then you are just you're blowing this so far out of proportion. You have no right to say those things.
And it was a glorious victory to sacrifice, 300,000 American lives to end it when every other country managed to do it with the sacrifice of about 10 lives in comparison.
Yeah. Well, you could probably say that it kind of happened that way here in the North, where slavery just kind of died over time. And
just became unpopular.
Right.
And it probably would have become unpopular in the South, too. And they wouldn't have been perhaps so rigid if on not wanting to give up that aspect if they hadn't been beaten.
All they would have done is exactly what happened: the building of the agriculture machines that made slavery, you know, unnecessary. I mean, it did cost an awful lot to house and to the initial purchase of a slave, and you had to house them, and then you had to keep them in line, and you always had to worry about revolts, and you know. It was a big deal.
Well, the country was built on slavery, and it wasn't just built on black slavery. I mean, the black slavery was unique in that it was like the children of slaves were also slaves, but
right.
People were kidnapped over Europe.
Indentured servants were always, you know, they could always get out of it.
Well, when they could get out of it, but oftentimes their indentured servitude would be extended for whatever reason, and it's the master, the owner, or whatever that's getting it extended.
Yeah, right. Not enough crops this year, okay. Joe. We're gonna tack another 5 years on.
You just didn't do things right. Sorry, you weren't a good enough servant.
You know, there was an article, and everyone's been posting it. The forgotten Irish slaves.
Yes.
And I got it on my to-do list and to read. It looks like a pretty good one.
I've read stories like that in the past, and I don't even know what the value is necessarily of discussing whether, you know, obviously people of different colors have been slaves and slavery is still going on today. But I think that there's a really interesting piece that you brought to the table here, Conan. I've read it before. It's called The Tale of the Slave.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it really breaks it down, the different levels of slavery. And that's why I asked earlier, you know, what percentage of slave are we today? Because you said, you know, you used the word serfdom. And really said we're 30% slaves, and this really does break it down into seven steps of slavery. It was written by Robert Nozick, and it's in the book Anarchy, State, and Utopia, and it goes as this: consider the following sequence of cases, which we shall call the tale of the slave, and imagine it is about you. Number one.
So imagine it's about you. This is great.
Right. Number one, there is a slave completely at the mercy of his brutal master's whims. He often is cruelly beaten, called out in the middle of the night, and so on. So this is, I think, when we see the media today of the plight of the black man, the early black man in the U.S., this is what we think. The master is he's tying up Kuta Kinte on the post, and what's your name? Your name is Toby.
Right.
And that's what we think of. That's what real slavery is. And I'm thinking that that's number one is number one slavery right
there. Yeah, absolutely. Number one slavery. I don't think there's any argument number one slavery.
So 100%. The man had no rights at all. He is everything. He is not allowed to pee. He's not allowed to eat. He's not allowed to sleep. He's not allowed to do anything unless his master says he's able to do it.
It would be like what Lincoln called pure tyranny.
Right.
Yeah.
But number two isn't much better.
No, it's not. Number two, the master is kindlier and beats the slave only for the stated infraction of his rules, not fulfilling the work quota and so on. He gives the slave some free time.
Now, largely, this is what people, slave owners in the South, would say about themselves, is I'm a pretty good slave owner. I don't beat them much, and I give them some time.
Yeah, like the plantation down the hill. I mean, we're so much nicer to our slaves. They never run off. Like they're always having these problems where the slaves are running away, and we don't have that problem.
It would be a little bit like the Babylonian slave system where they discovered they could get more work out of a slave if they gave them something approximating a weekend.
Yeah, I you know, you've got to really wonder how you get a slave to work when they don't really have a stake in it, you know? I mean, at that point, it's all stick and not very much carrot. This is kind of how it comes with employees and incentives. There's no bonus plan. There's no Christmas bonus. There's no, incentive plan based on performance or anything like that for slaves, or not as much.
Yeah, there are many, many companies out there who are getting away from that. And I think those are usually the companies who start to suffer. If you don't have some kind of share profit plan where the people, the employees actually have a stake in the company, you know, they start stealing. And they feel entitled to do these types of things. Are they cause a ruckus? Are they slack off? And they feel entitled to these things because they're not provided a stake in the company.
Well, I wasn't given a stapler.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know if it's always a financial stake.
I was told there would be stapler.
They... oftentimes it's just an emotional stake. And I think this is what a lot of the newer companies are kind of going for is that your opinion counts around here.
Right.
We put in a badminton court out back.
Okay.
You know, those, that kind of stuff. And, it works. It absolutely works. You know, just putting their name on a plaque, number one salesperson in the month of February, that kind of thing.
It does work a little bit anyways. The number three, the master has a group of slaves and he decides how things are to be allocated among them on nice grounds, taking into account their needs, merit, and so on. So that's kind of what we're talking about right now, where you get more free time according to, you know, whether you're doing your good a job, whether you're,
Right. So he's got more than one slave, and he has this, you know, whatever the assets are of the plantation, he decides how those assets are allocated amongst the slaves. And okay, obviously this would be done to some extent by the master. Sure.
Number four, the master allows his slaves 4 days on their own and requires them to work only 3 days a week on his land. The rest of the time is their time.
That's pretty good. I would think that as a slave, that's not too bad. That's a step up. So that's number four.
That's getting close to what we have now.
I think that's what it's trying to allude to, is essentially you have 4 days of your own and 3 days that you work for the government when it comes to counting the income taxes and all the different taxes and the regulations and all that stuff that's handed down on high from the government.
Right, because, you provide these 4 days of service, but he's providing your housing, he's providing your food, everything's provided for you. You just work for him for 4 days.
Yeah, the housing and food stink, but yes.
Right. Well, Number five, the master allows his slaves to go off and work in the city or anywhere they wish for wages. He requires only that they send back to him 3/7 of their wages. He also retains the power to recall them to the plantation if some emergency threatens his land, and to raise or lower the 3/7 amount required to be turned over to him. He further retains the right to restrict the slaves from participating in certain dangerous activities that threaten his financial return. For example, mountain climbing, cigarette smoking,
scuba diving, things like that. So, yeah, now we're full on into the sort of slavery that we might have today, because you don't have to live on the plantation. You don't have to. All you have to do is send back 3/7 of your earnings to master,
right?
And you're not allowed to do certain things that master says that's not applicable.
And if massa ever goes to war with the other plantations, you got to come back and defend the plantation, or go to war to protect the patriotic plantation that you were born on.
So we have gone through five of the nine steps here in the tale of the slave, and it gets very insightful here shortly. Your thoughts, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm on Skype, Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind this live edition of Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
Ridley.
And Conan.
Tell you about Quantum Vibe. Quantum Vibe is a liberty-themed, epic science fiction webcomic story, and it has recently concluded. But you can get Volume 3 of the series. It'll be available on the last day of June. But you can get advanced autographed copies purchased directly from Big Head Press the Wednesday before that at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. So just stop by Site 27 where we're going to be. You're going to be there. And if not, you can find it at bigheadpress.com. But the good news is Quantum Vibe Venus 23 has launched. It launched on June 8th. And so there's a little bit there for you to read. It's an all-new story set in the same fictional universe with new characters and some familiar ones. You can check out this liberty-themed webcomic at quantumvibe.com. Again, it is quantumvibe.com. We have been reading The Tale of the Slave, and who was the author of this one again?
Robert Nozick.
One of those. And we were on number 5. If you want to hear the rest, you can always grab the archive. It'll be available somewhere around midnight, maybe, Eastern time at freetalklive.com. But basically, he's ticking off different levels of slavery. In this case, in the last case, number 5, master allows the slaves to, they can work and do whatever they want. They just have to give 3/7 of their income back to him and be on call in case he needs them.
He can conscript them to fight his battles for him.
And of course,
to protect the plantation, of course.
What if the plantation is constantly at war like the United States? I mean, like, what is it, 200 out of the 230 years? How long has the U.S.
it's
been around?
It's quite a bit. And even in some of the years that they say we weren't at war, I really kind of wonder because,
Yeah, but we don't have a draft because somehow or another because we're so patriotic, we're able to, you know, the U.S. is able to convince enough young youngins to go and fight battles for them. Of course,
like you.
But my college was paid for.
Yep.
And it was I made really good money. And of course, I was a young dumb kid, and it was a nice job.
Yep.
It was nice. It was nice not knowing what I wanted to do with my life, and now it's all taken care of for me. Everything's laid out for me.
And then you find out how much that stinks, because very few people sign back up to keep staying in the military. Obviously.
Unless they actually go up the ranks and they're like, hey, I like bossing people around. This is all right. So you got your enlisted bosses and you got your officer bosses.
Lots of bosses.
Yep. Those are the guys who do well in the military.
And one other thing that from this number five example is the master doesn't allow you to participate in certain dangerous activities that might ruin his financial return. For
right,
example,
no sugary drinks.
Yeah, cigarette smoking, mountain climbing, these kind of things.
Mm-hmm. So number six, the master allows all of his 10,000 slaves, except you, to vote. And the joint decision is made by all of them. There is open discussion and so forth among them. And they have the power to determine to what uses to put whatever percentage of your and their earnings they decide to take, what activities legitimately may be forbidden to you, and so on.
So instead of the role of master deciding how much of your income is going to be taken, it's going to be every slave of the 10,000 slaves but you.
But you. So everyone gets together and is like, all right, we're going to set up this program to educate our kids. And we're going to take this amount of money from all of us and put it in this pool to do just that. It's kind of like, while you were gone, we all decided to get pizza.
Yeah, and now you owe $5.
$5. Right, but I didn't want any pizza. Well, I'm sorry.
You're going to have to pay, and if you don't, we're going to lock you in the closet.
Exactly.
I've seen the Facebook meme, and I can see obviously where this is going, so...
There's a little piece here. So number six breaks off and goes, let us pause in the sequence of cases to take stock. If the master contracts this transfer of power so that he cannot withdraw it, you have a change of master. And now have 10,000 masters instead of just one. Rather, you have one 10,000-headed master. Perhaps the 10,000 even will be kindlier than the benevolent master in case two. Still, they are your master. However, still more can be done. A kindly single master, as in case two, might allow his slaves to speak up and try to persuade him to make a certain decision. The 10,000-headed monster cannot do this. Or they can do this also.
Yeah, but when it comes to convincing 10,000 people, it's significantly more difficult than it is to convince one. And the argument from the monarchists is that, hey, government used to be a family business, and it was conducted reasonably well most of the time. There are certainly some great standouts that you could see, mad kings like Ivan the Terrible and mm-hmm. King Henry VIII. Those are the ones that history tends to focus on because they're interesting. But... most of the monarchs from the past did a reasonably good job.
Because they knew how to handle slaves. They didn't want, revolts every 5 years. They didn't want, slackers. They wanted slaves who didn't know they were slaves.
Well, it's like Prince Bandar from Saudi Arabia is always saying, in your democracy, if you really, really displease the people, you lose an election. And here in Riyadh, if we really, really displease the people, we lose our head.
Yeah. I mean, there are arguments for monarchies. I think that when the United States does business with them, they really fly in the face of their own principles, though. So the idea...
the United States supposedly is supposed to do business with everybody, and people are supposed to be allowed to do business with everybody.
I think a prime example of dealing with the 10,000-headed monster is just running for office or trying to get legislation done here in our country. You have to convince all these people to get it done, whereas if you did have that benevolent tyrant dictator, then you have much, much better chance of getting it done if you're the only lobby and you only have to deal with one guy.
And, obviously that person's going to be corrupted by the power and all those things too, but when you're dealing with individuals in a democratic situation, you're dealing with morons. You don't want me deciding how your brain surgery goes because I am a brain surgery moron. And you... my dear listener, and me, and all of us, we don't really know how best to run other people's lives.
Right.
But we go ahead and go to the polls every few years and decide how to decide to pick some jackasses, some liars and thieves, pick amongst the sociopaths we have to choose from, and, you know, let them go and prescribe to people how their lives are going to be lived.
Right. Here in Keene, we have a drainage problem in downtown Keene. It floods every time it rains.
It's an old lake bed.
And this is, they built Keene in a swamp, and that's what you get. And every house has a basement, which is something. There's three of us in this room that come from Florida. You don't build basements in your homes in Florida, and this is the same thing if you live in a swamp in Keene. But anyways,
we call them indoor swimming pools in Florida.
There's a flooding problem, and it's the way that the water is routed here and there, and they've been dealing with this for the longest time. And of course, they expect these politicians, these city councilors, to fix the problem. They're always complaining about how these things are going to, you know, how are we going to get this fixed? I'm going to say they're never going to get it fixed.
Right.
And they're going to spend a lot of your money not getting it done.
Right. It's like complaining that New Orleans floods. There are dikes up for a reason. You're 10 feet under the water. Who told you to build a city 10 feet below sea level?
You got to tear it down.
855-450-3733. They had a chance to fix that, and they didn't do it. 855-453, Free Talk Live.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in, talk about whatever's on your mind here on Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
Ridley.
And Conan.
855-450-FREE. We were talking about this this Tale of the Slave, which I think is a great little story. And we're going to get right back into that after I tell you about how to get Bitcoins. You go to expresscoin.com. They're the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, whether they're Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Dashcoin. They make it fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They are a licensed money services business, so you don't have to worry about any monkey business. You get your cryptocurrencies with a check or money order. Just start off at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, it's expresscoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL and get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency for no fee at all. No fee for cryptocurrencies using coupon code FTL if you get less than $40 worth at ExpressCoin.com. Again, it's coupon code FTL, ExpressCoin.com.
So now in lesson six, we just found out that you no longer have the one plantation slaveholder. You have 10,000 heads all telling you how you're going to do your business. And,
right. So instead of one on this slave, this imaginary slave plantation where we're sort of taking steps in getting more liberty, instead of one master deciding how everything's all the resources are going to be allocated and, you know, how what behavior is going to be put in place. There's 10,000 people deciding, but you are the only one that doesn't get a vote. You are part of the slave herd. I'm not sure what a group of slaves is. A sorrow. You're one of these sorrows, and but you don't get the vote. You're the only one who doesn't.
All right. Number seven, though still not having the vote, you are at liberty and are given the right to enter into discussion of the 10,000 to try to persuade them to adopt various policies and to treat you and themselves in a certain way. They then can go off to vote and decide upon policies covering the vast range of their powers.
So this is kind of how it is for me at the what we call the town meeting. That's what it's called. So once a year here in New England, in towns, and I think it's SB1 and SB2 towns is what it's called, mm-hmm. as opposed to cities.
Right, that's how our school board is set up here in Keene, where you can still do this. You can't do this on the city level.
But on the town level, in my town, you can go and you can you sit in the crowd and you talk about the budget or whatever, and then everybody votes on things that are above, I don't know, $40,000 or something like that. They kind of vote to approve the budget as it is or amend it, and you know, that's basically it.
And every now and then, some yahoo will come in and have some warrants. That's say we don't want another police cruiser, or some yahoo might say we do want another police cruiser, and we want to put it on the ballot so that people can actually vote on it.
And so, for instance, there was $5,000 put aside for the fire department fund this year, but before the vote was made, one of my fellow firefighters stood up and said, "Let's just move it to $25,000. Fire equipment is getting very, very expensive."
Right.
And I wouldn't disagree with him. Fire department equipment is getting very, very expensive. But, I mean, this is just how it's done. So they all decide together. Now, I get up and I speak on a relatively regular basis at these events on different subjects. I don't do it every time.
And you've become that guy, too.
Yeah, I am that guy. There is no doubt I'm that guy. It'll be a vote of all in favor, say aye. Thundering aye.
And then everyone looks and turns and looks at you.
Yep. All opposed, nay. Me, nay. And then everybody, you know. There's that guy.
Yeah, that's why when we go to our school deliberative sessions here in Keene, we sit everywhere but not in the same area because of just what you said. Because if we were all sitting in the one corner, it would be that much easier to identify us.
And that's actually brilliant, Conan. It's so normal for activists to bunch up, and it doesn't occur to them to disperse and spread themselves out. Like in a protest, it works better if you have the protesters.
Safety in numbers.
Each protester 15 yards away from the other, along a stretch of half a mile of highway. That's way more effective than the normal thing they do when they bunch up.
Right. So, we do split up, but we are communicating. We'll be on what it used to be Facebook Messenger, and now it's turned into Telegram, which is a really nice little app. And
it's
so
true.
We are definitely talking amongst ourselves, and we're debating amongst ourselves and strategizing, And I suggest that anyone who's trying to work through their city or towns, it's much easier in the towns to get things done. Like for example, Grafton, New Hampshire. How long was their silly session this year? It was like 11 hours or something, and they actually got things done.
Well, they in Grafton, they have nearly enough, because most people don't go to these town meetings. Now, politics in New Hampshire is much more a participation sport than it is most places around the United States, where everybody just sort of lets the politicians do whatever they want.
Right.
In New Hampshire and New England, it's less so that. But even so, a good percentage the majority of people do not go to these events. I'll let other people do it. And that's fine. In Grafton, that's true too, but they have enough activists to counteract the statists that do go.
Right.
And now in Grafton, it's basically a takeover, as close as you can get to a takeover, because they're trying to get enough activists there to brute force the numbers in another direction. It's nothing like that in my town. There are two... Well, I guess legitimately there are three free staters in my town. One of them doesn't really count. They aren't going to vote. They're not going to change a vote or sway a vote in any way.
Yeah, well, by the way, the numbers you're talking about are just typical of liberty types, where they do spread out and a lot of them don't vote. A lot of them don't agree with the system, and they'll to such an effect that they won't go to these events, period, because it's just a waste of their time.
It is a waste of our time.
Well, yeah. I would say that most definitely the 6 hours that we spent last year was a horrible waste of time. But
you're just banking it for the future,
but
really.
But they were talking about it for a whole month. I mean, there was one Warren article, the one where they spent a bunch of money advertising their warrants. The school was advertising their own warrant.
Yeah, that's wrong.
That's wrong, and by the way, it's against the law.
Yeah.
But they would just go ahead and blatantly doing it. But so that one warrant was talked about more than any of the other ones on the local radio, and it was in the newspaper. And there were people who went to this who never go to these sessions, who were actually that was something that was meaningful to them. That's why I do it. I do it to strike a conversation. I'm not so much like
it's a sacrifice, and I thank you for it. I will admit, when I go to these events, I have no foreseeable visible effect on the meeting itself.
Right.
Maybe I might change somebody's mind on an issue here or there, but ultimately nothing really changes.
No, right. You may find it more worthwhile, as always. I got a hammer in my hand and everything looks like a nail, but if you get video of the craziness that they the insanity that they descend into when you propose a bill that slightly decreases their powers or something, then that can be really useful. Sometimes those will go viral as
right
videos.
If you could if you have access to the YouTube freekeen.com YouTube channel, that 20-minute segment where we talked about this power that they have and this power that he abused, this law that they broke. It's an engaging debate. It's actually worth watching.
Well, of course, you probably couldn't do this because you were so deeply involved in the Warren article itself. But if it were me and I was going to be there, I wouldn't even care what was going on in the meeting. I'd just be questioning the politicians as they're coming and going from the meeting, mm-hmm. and getting that on YouTube. I just think that's golden, because every sixth one really freaks out or whatnot and makes a viral video.
I agree.
That's what draws attention to Freedom and Free State Project.
What qualifies as a viral video by your numbers, Dave?
Oh, I don't know. I guess maybe 3,000 hits in the first week.
It's pretty good.
But that would be considered, I mean, I've got videos that have done a lot worse than that, but eventually they seem to be viral. You know, like they might only get 1,000 hits in the first week, but over the following year, they get another 50,000.
We're going to continue to talk about this, the tale of the slave with the 9 levels of slavery.
We're getting closer to what we are now.
We're almost freedom here. Mm-hmm. It's almost freedom. So I think it's fascinating. There's the comparisons here done by it's Robert Norzik. 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. zog.ninja. Code FTL.
For over 75 years, Geico's kept an eye on the future, keeping customers happy with things like 24/7 customer support and emergency roadside service. And to prove it, here's one of our commercials from over 75 years ago.
At Geico, we promise to always find innovative new ways to serve you. In fact, we're so innovative, in 75 years, they'll listen to this old radio commercial and think, wow, they were innovative.
Wow, we are innovative.
Geico, saving people money for over 75 years.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
It's a terrifying thought. You're trapped somewhere without a radio and no access to GCN shows. A doctor's office. The DMV. Your mother-in-law's.
Come on, stay for dinner.
That's what makes the newly redesigned GCN Live app a true lifesaver. Listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programming on your smartphone, wherever you are. Download yours free on iTunes or Google Play. The new GCN Live app. Don't leave home without it.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever you want. We've been talking about this, the tale of the slave, as it is known. I've actually posted it up at our Facebook page. You can find it at facebook.freetalklive.com. And I've tweeted it out through Twitter, too. Twitter.freetalklive.com, if that's your preference. And it's just talking about sort of this Robert Norzik is giving his the different layers of slavery, starting at the very worst case, which is complete slavery, being at the mercy of your brutal master's whims, cruelly beaten and called out in the middle of the night and so on. It's Mark with you.
Ridley.
And Conan.
And we're going to go on with that. But first, I want to talk to Publius. Publius, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hi, Mark. I wanted to talk about free market justice systems, and to set the stage for that, I was hoping maybe you could discuss a little bit about what a free market policing force would look like.
Yeah. So are we talking about a justice system like arbitration, or are we talking about policing forces?
Like security.
Yeah.
A little bit of both, specifically dealing with how you'd address, let's say, a murder.
Okay. It gets difficult in these areas because we haven't seen it work out, but we have private.
It's not allowed.
Right. Well, that's true. Right. It's private security in this country. So, for instance, really most of the police work prior to 1850s.
Right. When was the last time private individuals took care of like a murder when they strung them up and hung them from the.
Well, there was private police in the form of private security even in the 19th century, and we still have security forces that kind of hold people for police till the police come, and then we have arbitration organizations that exist today. And the suggestion is that they can handle criminal cases just like they handle civil cases. Have I done good enough, Publius, or have I not gone far enough down the primrose path for you?
You've gotten most of the way there. So I think my concern is this. It's clear that private security forces do a pretty good job when it comes to protecting, let's say, property, relatively small crimes. However, I think things really break down when you start dealing with truly heinous crimes. And the reason why is this.
Okay.
If I'm accused in a system of justice like we have now of, let's say, murder, the police can just come knock on my door, take me to jail. If I try to run somewhere, they can extradite me. There's really not a lot of discussion. Really, they can just go forth and take me to jail if that's what's necessary. In a private system...
After they shoot your dog.
Yes. Unfortunately, it does turn out that way most of the time or many times. But let's say that in a private system, I commit what someone else considers to be a murder, but I say it was self-defense. Now, of course, I have my own private security force that I've hired, and they have their own private security force that they've hired. They don't want to fight because I'm not worthwhile. So what happens? The person who has hired the other security force says, I want you to go get this guy. He's committed a murder. My security force says he's only committed self-defense. Who wins? They don't want to fight over it. So do we both just end up, sort of not getting the services we paid for, or what happens there?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it's fascinating, right? But I mean, I'm pretty sure that people want to be protected from murders. And so what we've got is in the form of the free market is the best system for delivering people goods and services that they demand. So I would suspect, just taking a wild guess here, that the free market would provide you that, that system of protection. Now, obviously, it's not going to be foolproof by any stretch of the imagination, but it's okay because we don't have foolproof now.
But here's a potentially ameliorative situation that goes part of the way. We could leave all the trappings of government in place, leave all its basic ministries in place, for instance, if New Hampshire were free and independent, and just deny them the ability to tax. So it wouldn't be that difficult for them to raise enough money other ways to prosecute all the murders and jail all the murderers that happen in New Hampshire. What is it, 3 a year, 2 a year? It's not very many murders. Well, it's probably a little more than that.
I think, all right, so you bring up a good point. Who is actually paying the police? So now in this libertarian utopia where we have private security teams protecting us, what do they do when they come across a murder? Who is actually paying them? And I'm going to say it's probably going to be the insurance companies that are paying them through us. We're paying the insurance companies. The insurance companies are probably more interested in having the security teams on hand. So it's really going to be the insurance companies that are going to make the deciding call. What do we do with these heinous crimes?
So how about this, Publius? Getting a chance to listen to these guys, I think you're they're probably right. I mean, we have something similar in the form of automobile accidents, right? So we have two people that get in an automobile accident. They may not agree on what exactly occurred. Sometimes cops show up. Sometimes they don't. And the insurance companies, you know, they work it out amongst themselves. Okay, well, it looks like the bumper was hit here and the vehicle was struck in this manner. Must be their fault or whatever. So they take the whatever physical evidence they have, come up with a story, and they come as close as they can with the situations on hand.
And these guys are good at it because their money is at stake. I mean, they've got to hire people who know what they're talking about.
Does that make you feel any better, Publius?
Yeah, I think that's a really good point. But again, I think that sort of harkens back to the property issue. When you're dealing with a car accident, by and large, you're trying to give enough cash for somebody to repair the property of the vehicle. Sure. And repair the property of sort of their body as well. So it's mostly a cash compensation system. When it comes to murderers, or, you know, let's put that aside, let's just say assaults, we really do want to have some people off the streets, though, I think. And so, we probably need a prison system. And I just don't think that can be done on a private level in a way that really makes any of us comfortable. Because, after all, if you get a really, let's say, conservative police force, or insurance team or whatever you'd like to call them, and they believe that for some religious reason they need to lock up anyone who, you know, eats donuts on a Tuesday. I mean, it's possible there are some pretty crazy religions.
Sure.
Then we really don't want them jailing people, and you don't want to have your security force fighting theirs. So I do have concerns when you don't have sort of, you know, unilateral police force or unilateral means of dealing with criminals.
We don't need to go there in society. There's no danger of the ball rolling out of control uphill. And we can just set that issue aside and let the government continue to take care of it. Again, as long as the government's not allowed to initiate force against bystanders or anyone else, then there shouldn't be a problem.
Well, if the government can't initiate force, it's not the government.
Well, I mean, it could still have all the trappings. It just has a much smaller budget because it's not taxing. That's really the only difference, is it's not taxing. And you never know. Sometimes, like, it's like Rush Limbaugh used to say, the way the government could really grow its income would be to cut taxes.
Yeah, that's curious. As far as the definition of government is, if it's completely voluntary, like I can just opt out anytime I feel like it, like nope, no more. I don't want to pay into this. Can you define it as government? Because I know you can have two people getting together deciding what they're going to watch at the movie theater is a government. It's two people.
Well,
government.
Yeah, it's people getting together to agree on something. So I don't think I'm not too worried about this super hyper conservative government coming into power, Publius, because I mean there are some areas where that might occur. Abortion comes to mind, but you're not going to have, we already have that, right? In New York City.
Or anti-gay.
Anti-gay stuff probably too. In New York City, you have this Bloomberg fella decided, you know what's a good idea? We need a thinner New York City. Let's cut out sugary drinks of a certain size. So you've already got that crap going on. If you had some organization that was attempting to do that without a monopoly on violence in a given geographic area, they would be significantly less successful.
They would be laughed at.
I'd agree with you that we need places to lock certain people up. I'm not going to disagree with you on that. There are some people that simply can't handle freedom, and they need to be locked away, whether they're insane or not. It doesn't really matter to me whether they're insane or not. Functionally, they can't exist. They should either be shot in the course of their crimes or locked away so that they're not doing other things to other people. But I mean, wouldn't that be just a liability on the standpoint of an insurance company? I mean, I had my insurance company decide that I was too much trouble to give house insurance to. And, you know, after 20 years of doing business with this organization, sorry, you had a call. You called in and asked for you had a claim, and we don't deal with claims. You only give us money. We don't give you money.
Holy crap, that was it. Did you get picked up by another company?
No, sure. Insurance companies are a dime a dozen.
Yeah, and how much more were you paying, though, or was it about the same?
No, it was more.
Oh, wow.
So
yeah,
I mean,
they're in cahoots. They call each other up. They see the records. So, I mean, you can't escape these. You can't escape any longer. You can't go across the border and your crimes are forgiven. I mean,
right. There's no going desperado anymore. But my concern is, Publius, is that who's going to pay for incarceration? Because if you make the incarcerated person pay for their incarceration, then you incentivize organizations to incarcerate people beyond the period of time that they should be incarcerated.
We've got buttons to make, and we got all our criminals
right,
making buttons.
Right, we've got license plates to make,
exactly.
Or whatever. And that concerns me in that area. I haven't come up with the greatest answer. The best thing I could say is that you just take a space of land and fence it off, put guards around it or whatever, and then let them do whatever they want on the inside, kind of like a penal colony.
I would say the worst thing about the present-day prison system is that they're not actually paying back to the people who they wronged. That's the worst part. We're all paying to have these people incarcerated, and they're not actually paying back to the families that they victimized.
Publius, we've almost talked you into the dirt. Do you want to come back?
I'm all set. Thank you.
Thanks so much,
Mr. Scipio.
855. That's a Roman joke. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in with your topic.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.02 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $241. Antiwar.com reports UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is pushing for another humanitarian ceasefire in Yemen as the Geneva talks get underway, saying a two-week ceasefire for the start of Ramadan would allow large amounts of aid into the increasingly desperate country struggling under a Saudi-led naval blockade. The early news out of Geneva is not looking good, however, with the Saudi-backed exile government saying they are willing to discuss a limited ceasefire, but only if the Houthis agree to surrender every major city in the country as a condition. The Houthis have been pushing for an unconditional ceasefire and have been keen on restarting transitional talks, which effectively crumbled in January with the resignation of President Hadi, whose forces the Saudis are trying to reinstall militarily. The Hadi remnants don't appear keen to talk transition, however, at least not from their current weak position. While the first offer is obviously going to be rejected, the fact that the two sides both entered the talks at all shows a tacit recognition that a military victory simply is not going to happen, and that eventually they're going to have to come to terms. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports even though cannabis was legalized in Colorado, it has not been at the federal level. Therefore, companies can fire employees for using the substance, according to the Colorado Supreme Court. Brandon Coates, a quadriplegic medicinal cannabis patient, was fired in 2010 from his job as a telephone operator for Dish Network after testing positive for the substance. Dish never suggested Coates had worked stoned or used cannabis on the job, but dismissed him because of its no-tolerance policy for substances. Lawyers for Coates argued that Colorado law states it's illegal for workers to be terminated for participating in lawful activities off the job. A trial court and a court of appeals dismissed the claim, siding with Dish Network that medicinal cannabis use is not a lawful activity covered by termination laws. The Colorado Supreme Court upheld the earlier decisions. The panel of judges wrote in the opinion, "The Supreme Court holds that under the plain language of Colorado's lawful activity statute, the term lawful refers only to those activities that are lawful under both state and federal law. Therefore, employees who engage in an activity such as medical cannabis use that is permitted by state law but unlawful under federal law are not protected by the statute." A statement on Coates' lawyer's website said the ruling, though devastating for them, was important because there is previously no legal precedent for how a company could handle an employee who uses medicinal cannabis. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. Reuters reports a California judge has ruled that the state is obligated to pay $331 million in mortgage relief funds it used to bolster its finances, but stopped short of ordering that the money be turned over to homeowners hard hit by the mortgage and foreclosure crisis. Instead, Judge Timothy Frawley of Sacramento County Superior Court, in his ruling on Friday, said it is up to Governor Jerry Brown and lawmakers to come up with a plan to return $331 million that was part of the $25 billion national mortgage settlement of 2012 when the state has money available to do so. Robert Nasda, general counsel for the three groups that brought the lawsuit, said now that the California budget has swung to a surplus and Brown and lawmakers are debating what to do with it, the state is in a position to begin making payments. He said groups that sued California over the funds are seeking meetings with Brown and top Democrats and Republicans in the state Senate and Assembly on how to move forward with payments. It's not clear if that would be swept up into the budget talks that are currently underway between Brown and lawmakers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A report released Tuesday by physicists at Stanford University revealed that the entire known universe, from the whole of human civilization to the totality of matter and energy, is actually the fictional setting of a cop show called Hard Case. According to authors of the report, existence as we know it was created solely to provide the framework for the primetime drama that airs weekly in a parallel universe, and that every historical event prior to the show's September 2008 pilot, including the Renaissance, World War II, evolution, the September 11th attacks, and the presidential administrations of Washington through Clinton, never actually happened and are merely part of the elaborate backstory crafted by Hard Case creator and showrunner Dominic Egan.
We used to believe that our universe operated under immutable laws of thermodynamics and gravitational relativity, but now we know everything just comes from the minds of Hard Case's 12 staff writers. Overall, it seems like a very well-written show.
Physicists have theorized that the universe as we know it will cease to exist whenever Hard Case airs its final episode.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. This live edition of Free Talk Live with Mark.
Ridley.
And Conan.
855-450-FREE. Or you can use lrn.fm. That's our username on Skype. If you haven't called before, you just send a contact request one time and once we approve that, it's usually 5 minutes or something like that, then you can call in and sound quite a bit better. As a matter of fact, Publius, who just called in the last segment, he called in on Skype and he sounded great. It sounds like you're in the studio.
And he talked very fast.
Yeah, well,
he had a lot of information to get out there.
So we've been talking about this the story called The Tale of the Slave. And what it is sort of nine steps from complete slavery.
You know, Kuta Kinte.
Yeah. Here it is. The slave, there is a slave completely at the mercy of his brutal master's whims. He is often cruelly beaten, called out in the middle of the night, and so on. That's number one. And we just finished number seven, which is... Now, there's 10,000 slave masters. That's all the slaves on the farm. The slave master has abdicated and said that all the slaves get to make their decisions, and they vote in order to come up with the decisions on how to allocate resources on the plantation.
And you still can't vote, but now you have the option that you can actually persuade your neighbors, this 10,000-headed monster, yep, to actually make policies that might, you know, benefit you and the rest of the 10,000.
9,999 of the slaves on the farm get to vote. The only one who doesn't is you. Mm-hmm. But this in step number seven, you get to try to discuss things before the 9,999 vote.
Right. So number eight, in appreciation of your useful contributions to discussion, the 10,000-headed monster allow you to vote if they are deadlocked. They commit themselves to this procedure. After the discussion, you mark your vote on a slip of paper, and they go off and vote. In the eventuality that they divide evenly on some issue, 5,000 and 5,000 against, they look at your ballot and count it in. This has never yet happened. They have never yet had an occasion to open your ballot. A single master also might commit himself to letting his slave decide any issue concerning him about which he, the master, was absolutely indifferent.
So this is essentially how the voting process works in the United States. Now, in other countries, the parliamentary process, they vote, you know, for parties or whatever, and the parties take a certain amount of seats in the, you know, the parliament, but based on, you know, how many their different parties get. But in the United States, it is... winner takes all.
And well, the winner's Ben Bernanke. You're acting like the, or well, actually, I guess it's Janet Yellen now.
The banksters.
But you're acting as though the government is actually in charge. I'm not entirely sure that it is.
I wouldn't, right. Well, that's what we're told. And let's just go with the story for a second. The story is that you get to make the deciding vote. But, you know, they're always talking about with third parties that you shouldn't vote for a third party because you're throwing your vote away. Listen to me, Mr. and Mrs. America. If you voted for the party that lost, whether they're Democrats or Republicans or Libertarians or Green, your vote didn't matter. It didn't matter if your party lost by 10 votes or by 100 votes or by 1,000 votes or by 10,000 votes.
Right.
They lost, they lost. And so so is also true if your party won by more than one vote. If your party, Democrats, Republicans, Libertarians, or whatever they might be, I don't think Libertarians win too often, but if your party won... they didn't win, and they won by more than one vote. Your vote still didn't matter because one vote takes all. And that's a really important aspect to look at. This level of level eight slavery here is essentially what we have today because your vote is always the tie-breaking vote or your vote doesn't matter.
Right.
And you vote ahead of time, just like this slave does here. He writes down his vote ahead of time. He says, you know, I vote this way or that way. And they've never referenced his vote and never used his vote because they've never had a situation where it's more than 5,000, where it's 5,000 for and 5,000 against.
And I wonder if that's actually true in all of America's 10,000 person towns. You know, like this has never happened in any of those towns either. Maybe it has happened once.
You see it on the news a lot where they're having to recount the votes because
still,
it was so close.
When is it ever one vote?
That's very curious.
Yeah.
You know,
I can only name one case in my entire life where I cast a vote that made a decision.
I have a case where
it wasn't you know an actual you know government election. It was the Republican committee in Manchester.
Well, I had a situation where I decided I had to go to Florida for you know, a clemency thing for my my felony conviction, and I missed the town hall meeting in my town. I would have voted against this work truck or fire truck or whatever it was that they're buying because I don't vote for I don't vote for spending that is not my money. I just, you know, I'm morally against it. And it passed by one vote. And so I would have been there. My wife and I would have been there and we would have voted against. And then, bam, that would have been it for another year. It probably would have passed the next year when, you know, there wasn't the momentum to stop it. But that it does happen in New Hampshire. Keith Carlson, the activist of the year from the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance some year in the past, has chronicled many situations here in New Hampshire where state reps will win by one vote or as few as 10 votes. And there are, but I mean, we're talking about much smaller towns than 5,000 for and 5,000 against. In many cases, I'm voted in as the Republican delegate to the state convention in my town. I don't think I've had 100 votes cast for me. Now, I've never had anybody running against me that I know of. Maybe a write-in that I didn't know about. But, you know, these elections can be quite close here in New Hampshire. I guess it's the more rural aspect of it. So go on with number nine.
Number nine, they throw your vote in with theirs. If they are exactly tied, your vote carries the issue. Otherwise, it makes no difference to the electoral outcome. And it ends, the question is, which transition from case one to case nine makes it no longer the tale of a slave?
Yeah, so if you've got 10,000 masters, but they let you vote. And by the way, there's no operable difference between case eight and case nine. Your vote is always the tie-breaking vote. But if there's 10,000 people that decide how all of the resources are allocated, how people live their lives, whether they're allowed to smoke or mountain climb or all kinds of things, whether their business can be a business or not.
Right. Like you said, it might be soft servitude. But it's still, at the end of the day, it's still slavery, and you do not own yourself. And that is the worst part about this. You do not own yourself. You belong to someone else. Just think about it. Let that set in. You can't make your own decisions.
Ultimately, you belong to five of the nine people in the Supreme Court. Those are the ones that decide what's constitutional and what's not. And because there are, right now, hundreds of screaming Republicans shaking their fist at their radio saying, but this is a republic, you have rights. Well, I've got news for you. If you had rights, then the Supreme Court wouldn't be ruling on them because you'd have a right. The Antonin Scalia, probably the most conservative.
Defining those rights.
Right, they're defining those. They say all rights need to be attenuated. Well, if you're attenuating someone's rights, they don't have a right. There are 20,000 gun laws in a country where, I mean, and I just use the Second Amendment, not because I'm a big Second Amendment guy. I'm not a small Second Amendment guy either. I just use it because it's, it's so obvious. There are 20,000 gun laws in a country where it says a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. It says, shall not be infringed, and there's 20,000 gun laws, and I can't imagine they're doing anything but infringing. So, I mean, obviously, freedom of speech, freedom of the press. I think the world, Reporters Without Borders rated the United States at, in the 40s as far as press freedom goes. So don't think for a second that it's all about the Second Amendment. I know a lot of people, that's their defining issue, but honestly, whatever guns were going to do to keep you free, that time has long since passed. The government has a system for taking rights away, and nobody's shooting them over.
Right, and if we were going to actually defend ourselves against this tyrannical government, we would kind of need tanks, drones, grenade launchers, bazookas,
well,
the whole nine.
No,
I mean,
that's
we could,
not true.
We could definitely pull the Appalachian ticket and fight from the hills and do a pretty good job.
I want to hear what you guys have to say when we talk about it here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. You can call in too, or LRN.FM on Skype. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business? CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. It's Mark with you.
Ridley.
And Conan.
855-450-FREE. Conan, your project, Black Sheep Rising, tell me about it a little bit.
Once a month, it used to be once every week, but we had to cut it back a little bit. We do a variety show, a late night variety show. We talk a lot about what's going on here in Keene. We have some of the activists here in the area. We get together and we shoot the you know what, and we just talk about, you know, the things that matter to us.
Where can people find it?
Well, blacksheeprising.org is the website. You can also get it on iTunes, on Stitcher. You can go right to the YouTube channel, Black Sheep Rising.
Check it out. Let's go to Chris calling in from Connecticut, listening on TuneIn. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, good evening, guys. This is Chris from the police state of Connecticut. Conan had mentioned before, yes, well, hey, there's no other way to explain it when they say you can't own certain weapons. At any rate, well, I guess by that definition, if I could digress, then we're all at a police state since we can't have our own pocket nukes and drones. But
this is true.
Backing up, yes, nukes. Backing up, Conan had touched on a subject how we don't really own ourselves here, and I just wanted to illustrate that in one way. And that would be, I had a little story to tell about this. getting a little nervous. I'm on like 150 radio stations. Here I go. So, Mark, let's just say that you bought some tainted lemonade from some 8-year-old selling unregistered lemonade on the side of the road in Keene, all right?
Yep.
You went home, and heaven forbid you got sick, and, you know, you passed in your sleep, unfortunately.
Die? Okay.
I'm not wishing this on you. I'm not that crazy guy who calls in and heckles you all the time.
Yep.
And now, to illustrate how you don't own yourself, I mean, your wife and some members of your society, your Shire Free Church, couldn't then just take your body without calling anybody, go out in the backyard and burn it in a funeral pyre. No, could they? That would get them in some sort of trouble.
By the way, that's the way I want to go out. I'm all about the funeral pyre. I don't want to be buried and my body decomposing in the ground and just leaving whatever contaminants in the ground. Yeah, burn me up and or you know what? Or grind me up and put me in some ceramic or in some paints.
I'll paint
something out of me. Or at least grow a tree on top of me.
I'll feed you the pigs. How's that?
That'll work just fine.
You know, in my case, I actually have these things sort of laid out. My wife's clear on what it is that I want done. I've contracted with Alcor at alcor.org to have my head lopped off and deep frozen because I want to come back. So I don't know how that figures into your scenario here, but
you don't want to upload with the rest of us to the Matrix?
I'm ready when the time comes. Yeah.
Okay, because that's where I'm going.
Chris, I guess he's gone. We lost
him. Oh no!
Police state of Connecticut went out and got him. All right, let's go to Carrie. Gary, listening to KMass. You're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind, Gary?
Hey, how are you guys doing?
All's well.
Say, I hear you all talking about this race issue. Quit TV a year ago and started listening to the radio. All I've listened to is you folks and Alex and the Coast to Coast channel, and you guys are all great for getting stuff out here like you do, but the one thing I never hear anybody talk about is we're humans. And nobody says anything about we're all humans on this planet. It's all about the color of our skin.
Yeah, I think you're right.
We're all, you know, got the internal same thing, every one of us.
Same species.
Different language and a different color. Why don't we accept the fact we're all humans together on this planet?
Yeah, I'm with you, Gary. Absolutely.
I think it's all about the competition and it makes life more interesting when we can fight and have drama and, you know, do these things. I think it's way blown out of proportion. But yeah, it really seems like there are some people out there who just got to have it. I dated a woman who, it seemed to me, I didn't love her at the end of the day unless we had a fight every now and then. And it's like, wow, that's what's up with that? So that didn't last very long, by the way.
Well, I guess it's just every one of us on this planet have the me complex pretty bad.
Indeed. You know, Gary, thanks for bringing it back for us. I appreciate it.
Yeah, you bet. Yep. Love you guys.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Exactly the right thing to say. Thank you so much. 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm on Skype. Let's go to Alex calling in New Mexico. Alex, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, how you guys doing tonight?
All's well.
I wanted to talk about, you know, nobody ever talks about how Martin Luther King and, like, people like Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and John Lennon, they were all questioning our status quo, you know, and even the rapper back in Tupac Shakur, he was challenging the status quo about how the government is all in power, but yet the majority of people, they don't agree with what's going on in the Middle East or like what our economy is. And they just, and whenever they talk about these openly, and they a lot of them end up dead because they're such high profile people, and they end up dead because they are questioning the status quo. And there's actually been declassified documents about a court case back in like the 90s with Martin Luther King's family, and how it is implying that the FBI and the CIA were the ones who were involved in his murder. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I don't know. I haven't researched that court case that you're talking about. But, I mean, there are people that are questioning the status quo right now that have some level of profile, and they're not getting killed. Like, for instance,
But are they questioning the correct status quo? Are they protect? A lot of these guys are talking about banksters and the 1% and all this and that. They're not actually. Pointing the finger at the right lizard people.
I don't know. I mean,
yeah, and no, that's what I'm saying. Like, I was listening to this documentary today, and it was on Gaddafi, you know, and how he. I know he did a bunch of atrocious things, but at the same time, not a lot of people know that he was trying to switch over to
their own currency.
Selling gold, gold as a currency, the African dinar, and they were trying to switch that over to the oil and make it that only sold.
There is a conspiracy theory out there that all modern wars have been fought over essentially, people trying to get off of the petrodollar system. And I think it's fascinating. I haven't researched it thoroughly enough to be able to debunk it. I don't know any of these situations that that's not the case, but you'd think that someplace like North Korea or whatever would go ahead and get in good graces by, you know, getting on board with the petrodollar situation. What are they getting out of it?
Exactly.
I don't know.
And also, you know, Ron Paul, he actually was questioning Congress, asking them about if they did switch over to gold, like, would we be able to purchase it? But the fact is, we haven't held any gold since 1937.
Oh, yeah, it's already been shipped off to the aliens. We don't have any gold on this planet anymore.
What are you talking about? Thank you for the call, Alex.
You're welcome. You have a good day. Okay?
That's crazy. Aliens want antimatter, don't they?
I don't know what they want. They want sex with our women.
Okay. Mars needs women. 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. I'm not sure what any of this is about.
Not attorney spokesperson. Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937. Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Researchers at Princeton University's Department of Sociology have made a major leap in our understanding of social interaction.
We conducted trials in 90 supermarkets across the country and found that essentially 100% of people disapproved of having a stranger hit them across the face and then expose their genitalia right in the middle of the supermarket, which we found very interesting.
Researchers observed similar reactions when the subject hurled shopping carts toward unsuspecting shoppers, stood in the deli section rubbing cold cuts against his chest, or got right near cashier's ears and began loudly singing Yankee Doodle.
In this particular trial, we had our subject, Kevin, take off his shirt, tape a banana to his forehead, and charge at various shoppers like he was a rhino. Within 20 minutes, store owners called the police and he was arrested, allowing us to come to the conclusion that this type of behavior is still considered at least somewhat taboo.
This is the Onion News Network.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in, talk about whatever's on your mind. This live edition of Free Talk Live with Mark.
Ridley.
And Conan.
855-450-FREE. You need to protect yourself online. Your internet service provider is likely saving your surfing history. Criminals are sniffing your Wi-Fi packets. Governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet. Not to mention the NSA sweeping up metadata. ProXPN can solve all of that. Simply download an app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, or even Linux. Go through the easy setup and then just connect to the internet, and you're protected from everything. No more prying, no more spying. I shouldn't say everything. You're protected from all of the stuff I mentioned, plus other things. One account works for all your devices. No need to separate account to get a separate account for each device. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you'll get 50% off the regular monthly price. If you go to that landing page, you get 50% off, and that's basically $5 a month. That's for the lifetime of the account, no matter which premium account you go with. So, you go, by the way, the premium account will get you unlimited bandwidth with servers all around the world to access, the ability to privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits. You get all that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. So you go to proxpn.com/FTL and use promo code FTL50, and you'll get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. proxpn.com/FTL50. Let's go to Vince. Calling in from Indy. Vince, you're on Free Talk Live.
How are you gentlemen doing?
Great. Listen, Vince, you have been calling us for so many years. I just want to thank you, Vince.
Well, I've gotten very busy in my life.
Yeah. No, I mean, I said you have been calling for so many years. You've been calling for, you've been one of the longest, long-time listeners of Free Talk Live.
Oh, yeah. I still listen to you. It's just. I wanted to say something about the policing powers of the government.
Yes.
And this one gentleman talked about the tax warrants. We had a school corporation, and this was what they did here, is that they wanted a revenue bond to be passed this last primary election here in May. And you know what? They got the teachers, a lot of the teachers participate in these things.
Oh, yeah, the teachers are basically the ones that make the decisions when it comes to these school things, because so many people don't go and vote on this stuff, or they ask their friends who have talked to teachers and that kind of thing. Everybody wants to know, what do the teachers think?
The teachers, administrators, and the family members of the two. Those are the people who come out to these things. And sometimes you'll get some knucklehead like, I don't know, this guy, who goes out and gets his, loses 6 hours of his life sitting through all this bull crap.
Vince?
They do threaten, I don't know, the word threat is okay, but
they basically will withhold recommendations for students that are graduating and wanting to go to college who need the reference letter from a teacher.
They'll withhold it when? Under what conditions do they withhold these reference letters?
Well, if the revenue bond doesn't pass.
I see. So they're just going to screw all the students, whether they support it or not? Gotcha.
Yeah. They want to, I guess if they want to go to another state-run institution of higher learning. So that's how these people utilize the policing powers of the government. So.
Yep. That's what they do. They use the power that they've got in order to get the votes that they want. The fact is when you're talking about public school, thank you for the call, Vince. Appreciate it. When you're talking about the government, especially schools, you're talking about the organization that demands that you pay for generally the worst school in the neighborhood. I mean, when you look at public schools and you compare them to the other schools that are around, you take these government schools, you compare them to the other schools that they compete against. The government schools, everybody's got a finance, and they're generally the worst one in the geographic area. If you want a better education, you're not sending your kid to the government school, generally. There may be some situation somewhere where a government school is better than some private school, but it is a rarity. For instance, my son is homeschooled. Nobody's sending me any money to homeschool my son. But they demand that I send them money every single year, actually bi-yearly here.
Or they'll take your house from you.
Right. And that money could have gone to my son's education. So essentially, they steal my kid's money because they want to send their kid. They want to finance these teachers at the school.
It's not their kids. It's the poor kids, Mark. It's the kids that can't afford to pay that, I don't know.
They always say that. But if they wanted a means-based scholarship, they could have a scholarship based on income. I mean, if that's a damn lie, and I hate damn lies.
If they were just to end property tax right now, I mean, you would have so many older folk here in the community. Almost all of a sudden, they have a bunch of money, a pool of money. Do you think they're just going to buy yachts with it? You think they're going to? No, they're going to have money, and they're going to want to do something with it. They're going to want to have their name on the side of the building saying that I gave $10,000 to this to publicly or to educate these kids.
I would expect that they would do exactly as you say.
Or maybe they're going to eat and heat.
Exactly. But you know what? That money is still going into the community. They have to spend it somewhere. So someone's going to make that money. So the local deli is going to make more money, and he's going to have more money to send his kids through, to educate his kids.
I don't have any, I don't disagree with what you're saying.
The same thing goes with the yacht builder, by the way, the guy building the yachts. It's not being dribbled down the drains.
The argument that it's for the poor kids is fallacious simply because the public school system isn't made for poor kids. It's a middle class babysitting service.
Correct.
It's a middle class welfare babysitting service.
That's why it's so long.
When I go to the school in my town, when I happen to get over that way, we're told all the time it's one of the best schools in the state, and it probably is. But what
does
that have?
And that's not. Yeah, that's not saying much.
Right, it's one of the best government schools in the state because they'll never say that it's good compared to one of the private schools. They don't say that. And
only the turtles are allowed into the race.
Right, But when I go by there, whether it's the kids getting picked up or whatever, I'm seeing all new cars. I know what these houses these people live in. There are only like 600 houses in my town. I've got a general idea of how these people are living. Their kids are not poor. They are not poor. They make as much money, if not more, than I make, and they steal the money from my kid to send their kid to the crappiest school in town. Not because they're smart, but because they're brainwashed. I cannot understand for one second. Please, dear God, call me and explain to me why it makes sense that you send your kid to public school and steal money from my kid at 855-450-FREE. I find it enraging. That this is, you could just send your kid to the public school like the rest of us do. Get in there with the dum-dums and, get taught all the other stuff that the other kids that we wouldn't want to teach anybody.
And maybe get bullied. or, you know, or maybe get hit on the road driving their bicycle to school, or any number of things could happen. Or maybe just spending a decade of their life not learning a damn thing.
Or putting condoms on cucumbers, or saying the pledges to the flag. There's 100 different things that go on at public schools that somebody might have a problem with. But for me, it's specifically about the learning environment. The learning environment of public schools was designed in the late 19th century to make factory workers. There's bells. You can't go potty unless you ask. I mean, everything about public school is basically hive mind bullcrap.
And they're only taking it to the next level with this new Common Core crap. They need desk monkeys. These businesses are tired of having to retrain students right out of high school. And, Common Core is going to fix all that, because that's going to make perfect desk monkeys.
I have no idea. It's not something I consider think about in my life, the Common Core thing. But I can tell you that I don't believe you can make a kid creative or make them passionate about something. You can't instill in them, intelligence
But you can take it away.
But you can take it away. And that's what government school does. It crushes their passion. It destroys what they're excited about. And it disenfranchises them from the concept that they can learn themselves. That's what's so deadly about our government school system. And this is why I say, if you can read, you can do it in spite of a teacher.
Yeah.
Because all these bumper stickers praising these teachers, I know there's some great teachers out there, but it's not because of the educational system. It's because they go around it. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
It's the end of quarter clearance sale at Lumber Liquidators. We're North America's largest specialty retailer of hardwood flooring, and we've got 10 million square feet of top quality floors for as much as 77% less than other stores. Get over 200 styles of real pre-finished hardwood from just 49 cents, 40 styles of beautiful bamboo from $1.59, plus deals on popular American and European laminates and more from an incredible 39 cents. And pay no interest until 2017. Hurry, clearance sale's going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated, so send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-453. It's 855-450-3733. Check out the AMP page at amp.freetalklive.com. Why would you do that? Why would you want to support Free Talk Live? And when I say support, what I'm talking about is giving us money to advertise, market, and promote. That's what AMP stands for. We don't use AMP money for, you know, paychecks or anything like that. Why would you want to do that? Well, if you believe in the ideas of liberty, I'm going to make a radical statement. The radical statement is your $5 a month that goes towards the AMP program is going to be better used than any other donation to any other liberty organization I can think of. They're all funded with, everybody's getting paychecks from the things you're donating. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. I'm just saying that we get our paychecks through advertising and that sort of thing, the talk radio model. And so therefore, all your money's doing is going to promote the ideas of liberty. Every new radio station, every new podcast listener we get, it's, you know, and that's your money's straight buying that.
Yeah, I probably should have said this before becoming a co-host on Free Talk Live, but I would guess that freetalklive.com is probably a more effective organization than Campaign for Liberty is, it'd put a tiny fraction of the cost. That's my guess. What has Campaign for Liberty done exactly?
What have they accomplished? I don't know. I know that the money that I donated to the Ron Paul campaign, that he took the leftovers there and dumped it into Campaign for Liberty, and it left me kind of missed.
Well, it was better than throwing it away, I'm not saying they haven't done anything, but if they've done something really important, you'd think I would know about it.
You know, I would say that AMP donators, they are the producers of the show in a way.
Yeah, in many ways they are.
So you have your advertisers, you make that money, but you know, you can directly contribute to the show and be a producer of the show and of spreading liberty.
You really don't know how true that is. In that AMP forum that we have on Facebook, it's part of the benefits of becoming an amplifier is that anybody who's ever been an amplifier gets added to this Facebook group, and they they interact in there with other amplifiers, and we come to them with issues of the show. Like, I ask them business questions and that sort of thing. They really are our board of directors. And if you want to be on our board of directors, all it does is cost you $5 a month.
Wow.
amp.freetalklive.com. And there you go. That's what you should call it, the board of directors. That way people can put it on resumes.
I think AMP sounds nice. It sounds hot. It sounds fiery. But yeah. But board of producers or board of directors of Free Talk Live, that's strong right there.
It does sound neat.
Ian, are you listening to this? Board of directors.
You know, it's night off. He's probably high. 855, 450 free.
And anyways, we had such harmony on this show this evening. I mean, why would we?
Let's interrupt it now and continue our discussion about warfare.
We were talking about disagreeing. You were saying something to the effect.
I said Second Amendment. We should have tanks, drones, bazookas, grenade launchers, flak jets, the whole nine. Everything that our U.S. military has, we should have. According to the Second Amendment,
the people should be allowed to have it. Yes, we're in agreement on that.
Except for nukes. I think that nukes are are offensive weapons as opposed to defensive weapons. You can't employ a nuke against an individual. You can only employ it against a group of people, and some of them are always going
to
be innocent.
I think most people will come to the conclusion that this is not a worthwhile endeavor. If I do nuke my neighbor, it's just going to come floating right back onto me, and we're just going to kill all my chickens.
Oh, generally, yeah.
All right, so it's not a good idea.
And it's been done, sort of. I mean, people have done things that are almost that crazy.
Yeah, but the world's full of crazy people, and you don't want a nuke in the hand of somebody who's, like, clinically insane.
And that's the argument they are having, the conservatives are having with the whole Iran nuclear program.
Yeah.
Okay. That these people are crazy, and... well, they just hate us. That doesn't mean they're crazy.
They probably hate us for a variety of reasons that aren't getting addressed. But you guys go ahead and...
So you were saying, I got the impression, that people would need to have weapons like that in order to fight the United States federal government. And
I'm going to say history tells us that no, that is absolutely not the case. There have been many cases... where the hillmen, the farmers, the countrymen, the minutemen have our American Revolution is a prime example where you've got guys with pretty much pitchforks.
Okay, so we're not even in disagreement.
No, I thought
we were going to have a good fight here.
I'll go ahead and take
Wait,
this
no,
one.
Mark and I are actually in disagreement sort of on this. So explain your position about the use of the idea of using violent force against a government when you are living there.
Well, I'm not sure what you're referencing.
Well,
exactly.
Okay, when you're referring to when you're talking about the federal context, you've, I think, in the past said that it is not viable for Americans to fight the government violently because they don't have the right weaponry.
Okay,
and I think it is not viable, but for different reasons, and I'll go into that in a second.
Yeah, what I would say is that people there's not enough people willing to fight the government, so claiming that you're ready to fight the government
because
just makes you crazy.
Because they are unwilling slaves. They don't know that they're slaves yet. Until that happens, you're right. It can't happen.
And the people that do want to fight for all the wrong reasons. So I guess I'm just not interested in it.
Keep
from that
them
standpoint.
Gays out of my
whatever their reasons
ice cream
are.
Parlor.
Right. I just, it's so, boring to talk about. But yeah, I mean, the federal government has lots of different types of weaponry, and they will probably not lose if it comes to, a full-on, some kind of dystopian battle. But I don't think it will. I think ultimately, the federal government's going to spend itself into insolvency, and its support's going to erode from the bottom.
Well, the question is this going to be a collapse like the Soviet collapse or the Yugoslav collapse? And I think it's an open question. It could happen. There could be fighting. But I think the reason you don't use physical violence against the government in a fight for liberty is because the chances of you getting liberty out of it are so low.
Slim.
And there are so many ethical consequences for it. It's so difficult to control a war in any form or fashion. That's why you don't fight. But it's not because they'd lose. I mean, if 1,000 Americans decided they wanted to fight the government and use guerrilla tactics like Michael Collins or something, they would be extremely effective, and they wouldn't need anything more than 19th century weapons. That is not the reason why you don't fight. It's because of the fact that you wouldn't get freedom out of it, and you would have ethical problems. You know, there are too many innocent people would get hurt. And is it even right to kill guilty people?
There's another thing those 1,000 Americans could do that would be much more productive, and that's just to stop paying their taxes.
Yeah,
if you get 1,000 people in the same area...
Well, there's
area,
already... there are way more than 1,000.
No. I mean in the same area. If you can get a whole community just to stop paying their taxes, that would be...
Property
taxes. Yeah, exactly.
Okay, yeah, you're right. That would be effective. But you wouldn't need 1,000. You'd only need 50 or 60 probably.
Well, so we have 23,000 here in Keene. I mean, how many do you think we would have to have just stop paying in this area?
If you wanted to stop paying property taxes and income taxes, it's relatively easy. The churches have been doing it all along. So you create a monastery or something. You call you create a religion of some sort. You get a monastery for your religion,
You're doing it by the book.
Well, they don't pay. Now, if there's a murder in the monastery, the cops are going to come and they're going to investigate that. So that you're not getting rid of the government by doing this. But many religious organizations don't pay property taxes. They don't pay income taxes, like any of them. And so it is certainly possible to use the words that they have on paper to avoid doing those things. That's you know, that's one of the advantages of a religion. Now, what does a monastery look like? Could it just be a gated community? I suppose it could be. It's just the issue of defining it. I would say one of the reasons the Shire Free Church that we've set up here in Keene, actually, you can go find out about church at shiresociety.com/church. You can find out about the Shire Free Church in your area. But well, the problems that we've had here is we're already a known quantity. When Ian Freeman and Mark Edge are starting a church up, everybody knows, you know, they think they all know what's up. It doesn't have anything to do with, you know, you guys just... You don't want to play by our rules and blah, blah, blah. You know, they've been telling us all along, if you, you know, if you just work within the system,
you can just run for office, Mark.
Well, they don't say that. They say work within the system. And working within the system, setting this thing up, that's what it
they
is.
They hate you more for doing this than they would if you just did a property tax revolt. I liked Kat Canning's approach better, the initial approach back in 2006, roughly, you know, where she just stopped paying her property taxes. I think she eventually gave in, but
that's what because they'll take your house from you.
Exactly.
Well, there's a process that one can go through while having the house taken, and depending on what house it is, that can really make that difficult for the authorities.
This is basically the same idea with Ian's don't take a plea, even on the simplest parking fees. And it's not his thing, but he really is on top of this. If one person does it, they win. But if 100 people did it, before you know it, they're not accepting parking tickets anymore. They're not giving them out because it's not worth their while. They lose too much money in the process, and so it'll go away.
Well, they certainly just stop taking parking ticket trials. They'll just drop the tickets as you fight them. Thanks for joining us. You can check us out in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Participate in the Facebook page at facebook.freetalklive.com.
FreeTalkLive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.02 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,183 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $241. Antiwar.com reports UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is pushing for another humanitarian ceasefire in Yemen as the Geneva talks get underway, saying a two-week ceasefire for the start of Ramadan would allow large amounts of aid into the increasingly desperate country struggling under a Saudi-led naval blockade. The early news out of Geneva is not looking good, however, with the Saudi-backed exile government saying they are willing to discuss a limited ceasefire, but only if the Houthis agree to surrender every major city in the country as a condition. The Houthis have been pushing for an unconditional ceasefire and have been keen on restarting transitional talks, which effectively crumbled in January with the resignation of President Hadi, whose forces the Saudis are trying to reinstall militarily. The Hadi remnants don't appear keen to talk transition, however, at least not from their current weak position. While the first offer is obviously going to be rejected, the fact that the two sides both entered the talks at all shows a tacit recognition that a military victory simply is not going to happen, and that eventually they're going to have to come to terms.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports even though cannabis was legalized in Colorado, it has not been at the federal level. Therefore, companies can fire employees for using the substance, according to the Colorado Supreme Court. Brandon Coates, a quadriplegic medicinal cannabis patient, was fired in 2010 from his job as a telephone operator for Dish Network after testing positive for the substance. Dish never suggested Coates had worked stoned or used cannabis on the job, but dismissed him because of its no-tolerance policy for substances. Lawyers for Coates argued that Colorado law states it's illegal for workers to be terminated for participating in lawful activities off the job. A trial court and a court of appeals dismissed the claim, siding with Dish Network that medicinal cannabis use is not a lawful activity covered by termination laws. The Colorado Supreme Court upheld the earlier decisions. The panel of judges wrote in the opinion, "The Supreme Court holds that under the plain language of Colorado's lawful activity statute, the term lawful refers only to those activities that are lawful under both state and federal law. Therefore, employees who engage in an activity such as medical cannabis use that is permitted by state law but unlawful under federal law are not protected by the statute." A statement on Coates' lawyer's website said the ruling, though devastating for them, was important because there was previously no legal precedent for how a company could handle an employee who uses medicinal cannabis.
In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com.
Reuters reports a California judge has ruled that the state is obligated to pay $331 million in mortgage relief funds it used to bolster its finances, but stopped short of ordering that the money be turned over to homeowners hard hit by the mortgage and foreclosure crisis. Instead, Judge Timothy Frawley of Sacramento County Superior Court, in his ruling on Friday, said it is up to Governor Jerry Brown and lawmakers to